This video is about two modifications that I've made to a Marcotte M300. As of the making of this video, 53 hours of runtime have been accumulated with no known problems. Hello, I'm Russell Sherwood, and this is my Glass Air. It's powered by a Subaru EG33 six-cylinder engine. It has a Marcotte M300 reduction drive, and he's out of Quebec, Canada. And I've had some spline wear, and I've made several modifications that I think may help reduce that wear. This is an exploded view of the ring gear, prop shaft, and associated parts. There's a large bolt that goes through here and holds the two pieces together. Well, when it does that, it blocks this hole. When the bolt is in place, the spline and the ring gear is basically a cup. The oil cannot pass through here. It's plugged up by that bolt. It can get in there, but it can't go anywhere. It just is stagnant and stays right there. And, so what I've done is I've drilled four holes in the ring gear, and they pass all the way through to the spline side. So my thinking is, since the oil would normally come from the filter, go into the front of the gearbox, travel back, lube the bearing, and I'm thinking some of that oil will make its way into the splines, past the splines, and go back in for recirculating. The oil, in my hoping, is that it would also carry some of these metal particles that broke off. Okay, the second modification that I made to the Marcotte involves how do we adjust the preload on the two main bearings. There's a main and on the prop shaft and one on the ring gear. And these are tapered bearings. So when they're set in there, the preload is determined by how far apart these two pieces are placed. And they adjust that by putting a shim of different thicknesses in the spline here. And so as we get a thicker shim, it shoves the prop shaft out and it loosens the preload. If we get a thinner one in here, the two pieces get closer and closer, and we tighten up that preload. Now the problem I was having with adjusting the preload with this standard method of putting the shim in the ring gear was every time I took the gearbox apart, this shim was severely beat up, cracked, loss of metal, that type of thing. And so I wanted to come up with a different method and get rid of this shim. So what I've done on the aluminum nose cone, I've machined down the front bearing race stop, and that allows the stop to, the race to go further down before it hits the stop. Now the effect of that is I have the bearings are too close together now. So now what I have to do is basically the same thing as before. With a larger shim, I shim underneath the race to the proper distance with just working with the thicknesses of that race to get my proper preload in the bearing. Now it's a little more difficult to do than the old position, but it's not going to be moving around, it's not going to be throwing metal off into my splines, and so I think I'm going to have a lot better results with this method.